and stay there. You belong in that place, along with the rest of the world's most hardened criminals.
No! Please! I'm not a criminal! Please let me go!
What? Not a criminal? You're lucky you weren't killed on the spot. But that's not a problem. These other prisoners will do that. Guard! Watch over them and report to me once the other prisoners start torturing her. I wouldn't want to miss that.
All right, Captain.
No! No! I'm not a criminal. I'm sorry.
Oh no, your arm. It's bleeding from where you hit the ground.
Don't come near me. Don't hurt me.
Don't believe the captain. We're not going to hurt you.
You're a Christian, aren't you?
What? What are you talking about?
We're Christians too. My name is Grace, and this is Kate.
I'm Nina. How did you know I'm a Christian?
Because this is where the most hardened criminals are put, and in the eyes of the law, we are hardened criminals for following Christ.
Why are you here then? What did you do?
My father, he sent me here. He caught me with a Bible in my hand. I didn't hide it fast enough when he went inside my room. He was so angry. He was the one who brought me here.
Your own father did that? What about your mother? What did she do?
My father forbade her to see me. My sisters, they warned me about it. One day our parents will find out and they would not like it. They told me to stop being so stubborn, that I should just stop this Christian nonsense. I just kept silent and prayed for them. My mother found out, and she begged me to change my mind before father found out.
And now, not even all your family's riches could save you. Your own foolishness put you here, and no amount of money could ever change your father's mind. You already had it all. Why throw it away?
For what is a man profited if he shall gain the whole world and lose his own soul? Or what shall a man give in exchange for his soul? I didn't have anything until I had Jesus. And I still wouldn't exchange all the riches in the world for the peace, the joy that I have found in Jesus.
Foolish woman you are, go ahead, waste your life away.
My life will not be wasted. My story will be heard by others, and they would meet Jesus as well. How about you? What's your story, Nina? Why are you here?
I was caught hiding missionaries in my house. One of the people we helped in a medical mission went to the police and told them I had Christian missionaries staying in my home. They were taken somewhere else, and I was sent here.
And then the captain will decide what to do with you, but while waiting for that, why don't you listen to this other prisoner's story? She's been here the longest, and possibly the most hardened of all criminals here. Well, Grace, what do you have to say?
2 months ago, I was leading a Bible study group, and the police raided my house. They captured me and the rest of the group I was leading, and burned my house so that all the materials I had would be gone forever.
What happened to your group? Where are they now?
We were all taken to prison. I heard they had been released, but since I was the one leading them, they placed me in this cell. And I don't know what will happen next, but I'm sure God is in control, and He knows what is best.
I hope we'll be released soon.
You fools!
Captain, how long have you been there?
I heard everything. Don't you know? I have the power to decide whether to release you or not. All you had to do was to deny that you're Christians. But since I've heard everything, there's no more way for me to decide otherwise. Especially you, Grace. People have spoken against you and say that you're indeed a Christian. You're on your way to execution.
What?
And when would that be, Captain?
As soon as possible. Like, tomorrow. Now's the perfect time to pray and ask your God for a miracle. But I doubt He can do anything now. My mind is made up.
So be it. When I die, I would see my Lord, my God. And there is nothing more in this world that can compare to that.
Not even freedom?
If you would set me free, I would do everything all over again. I would still hold Bible studies. I would still tell people of God's love.
Tough one, aren't you? Well, we'll see about that tomorrow. tell people of God's love? Bah!
No! What shall we do?
We pray. It's the best thing to do.
Can't we do anything to stop grace from being executed?
A miracle would be good, but only if it's part of God's plan. Remember, He is in control. He is God.
Ah, tomorrow's another day, ladies. You better get some rest, if you can.
Morning came and the prisoners waited as the guard took away Grace.
What could be happening?
It's probably the end. We must stand firm.
It's over. Grace has been executed.
Oh no!
I can't believe it. The captain kept asking her if she would still change her mind about being a Christian. She said that it's not a matter of changing her mind anytime. She said she will never be anything but a Christian. She gave her life to Jesus and she belongs to Him. But you know what's more unbelievable? She shouted to everyone that Jesus loves us and that she still hopes one day we'd have a life that has Jesus in it.
We pray the same for you as well.
I don't understand. How can you still pray for us even though we captured you, put you to prison, and even put you to death?
Because that's the love of Jesus. And even though the world hated Him, He still loved everyone. He loves us so much. He died for our sins to save us because He wants us to spend a lifetime with Him.
Is that the reason why even if we've captured so many of you, killed so many of you, still, you never seem to disappear? You just keep growing and growing in number.
Because a life with Jesus is a life of peace, of love. It's a life like no other, a life that is abundant and full.
I see your faith, and it has always intrigued me. You're prisoners, and yet you seem freer than I am. Hearing how you talk about Jesus has made me want to have a life with Him as well. Will you tell me how?
Sure, we'd be happy to.